It's Sunday morning, just before sunrise. We're getting ready for the sunrise services, celebrating Resurrection Day at our church. And this is also called Easter morning, so called for the worship of the Babylonian lust and fertility goddess Ishtar, often celebrated with eggs and rabbits. And this, of course, is a rabbit. And this is how we celebrate our Easter bunny, by consuming one. We are dredging the bunny in flour. Butter frothing nicely in the pan. And now, the wabbit. Just gonna wound the wabbit on both sides. I'm getting the look for the Elmer Fudd talk. Warning, onions have entered the skillet. Now the carrots. The freckled shoulder. Mushrooms. Oh, it smells heavenly in here. Just periodically lifting the lid and giving this a stir. And now, the new potatoes. Nothing like new red potatoes. So tender, so tasty, so full of flavor. It's before sunrise, you know. We're getting ready for services on the beach at our church. And there goes the chicken broth. A lot of these ingredients prepared the night before. There goes the wine. Oh yes, folks, the alcohol cooks off of this. We're not going to come home and get crocked on Easter bunny stew. And this is tomato paste, about 2 tablespoons. And that is the little Herbe de Provence mixture. I'm trying to remember that
thyme,
was...
Thyme, marjoram, and basil.
Thyme, marjoram, and basil. Other recipes call for savory. If you've caught your own rabbit, or if you're using wild rabbit some way, caught or trapped or killed your own Easter bunny, then you may want to let it soak overnight in a brine solution just to take out some of that gamey flavor. This, however, was farm-raised rabbit. Good. While, of course, we would never eat a pet, well, under normal circumstances, we would never eat a pet, such as this creature. Unless, of course, we were fixing something with a little curry in it. Rabbits are wonderful. A farm-raised rabbit, pound for pound, is an incredible deal. The meat-to-feed ratio of young bunnies is the best out there. Well, chicken is slightly better. But if you want, a nice four-legged critter to eat, rabbit is the best deal, and so tasty. Giving it another stir. The actual official deglazing having taken place now with the liquid on the bottom of the pan. I can't tell you how good that smells. And now, here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, happy Easter day. I can't wait. Wabbit stew. And scraping all the good little bits of rabbit in there. You don't want to lose any of the delicious Easter bunny flavor. And what's the next step, honey?
Well, this is going to go into a 325 degree oven for about an hour and a half. I have the oven preset to start at about 10 o'clock, so it'll be done about 11:30.
Well, we have just gotten home from Easter sunrise services and then regular Easter services, and the rabbit is cooking in the Dutch oven, and we walked into the most amazing smell. This is magnificent, and I can't wait to plate up this Easter bunny. Sauteing now in butter in a black iron skillet. A little pressed garlic and some sliced onion. Mm-mm. And here you see the remains of the garlic and the onion, the garlic press, the knife, the cutting board, the beautiful cook, my cast iron skillet, my grandma's spring steel spatula, 40 or 50 years old. Older than many of you watching this video, and still hard at work. Now the onions and garlic have sweated a little, Melissa is adding some delicious kale. This is gonna be so good. Just a perfect side dish for that wascoey wabbit. There it is. A Dutch oven containing a type of provincial French rabbit stew. Okay, folks, a little secret here. A little bit of liquid smoke.
It's Maggie seasoning.
Maggie seasoning. What does it do?
It says it improves the taste.
It improved, unless I am greatly mistaken, a little bit of sesame oil. What's she shaking on now?
It's a little extra garlic powder.
A little. And I believe that was just salt. Okay. Steaming a little bit more. Hurry. Hurry. Hurry, hurry. Hurry.
I mean, that really doesn't make it go any faster.
Oh, that's cooking down nicely. The smell is incredible, folks. Just delicious. Between the rabbit stew and this kale with onion and garlic and sesame oil and other seasonings, the aroma in this kitchen is just incredible. More butter. This can't be a bad thing.
This is not a diet meal.
Not a diet meal. No, no, no. This is special. This is Easter bunny stew with kale. And I think you've got a special dessert planned, too.
Mm-hmm.
And the special dessert is kind of a
chocolate sponge cake topped with sliced strawberries and whipped topping.
Oh. Those of you who are complaining about a little bit of mess we make as we cook, look, this ain't the Martha Stewart show.
It ain't messy, it ain't good.
Nah, this is more like Julia Child. Oh, I dropped it on the floor. Well, the 3-second rule does apply. This is going to be good. Well, is it? Huh? Is it?
It's a little crunchy yet.
A little crunchy still.
Oh, man. I'm sneaking this shot.
She's mixed a little water with some flour and is now pouring that mixture in with the boiling vegetable rabbit stock. This is going to be so good. And that, my friends, is Easter Bunny Stew with a side of kale. Oh. I love Easter bunnies. Tender, tasty, delicious Easter bunnies. Good. Thank you, Melissa.
You're welcome.